Hello, my name is Matt Ho, and I'm the CTO of SundaeSwap. Today I'm excited to walk you through the first of what I hope will be many technical videos that SundaeSwap Labs will be creating. Our goal is to make Cardano a fantastic place for developers. In this video, we'll go through setting up SundaeSwap Labs toolkit for Cardano on a private blockchain. Let me start by showing you the web interface, which will be run on port 3200 by default. We put this together based on common tasks that we were doing over and over again using the Cardano CLI and a set of scripts. Given how frequently we were doing them, it was just easier to put them together in a web interface. The first thing we'll do is create a wallet. A wallet is nothing more than a string with, you know, potentially a mnemonic label. This is a development wallet, so don't think of this as something you put real money in just for development purposes. You can store this in a cookie, local storage, what have you. So I'll go ahead and create a wallet here. Creating a wallet will fund it with some initial tokens. You can see they've arrived there. We can also add any number of tokens to it from that treasury address. We can also mint tokens. So I can mint, say, Sunday and give myself a number of them. In addition to viewing the tokens, I can also look at balances, so I can see, you know, where the tokens are. So if I'm looking for Sunday specifically, I can find that pretty easily. In addition to being able to fund and mint tokens and things like that, we also have a GraphQL interface, which you can reach via /GraphQL. That GraphQL interface has a number of things you can do. If you look at the documentation, you'll see that you can do things like query the fees, look for the UTXOs, find the wallets. You can also mint new tokens, build a transaction, sign a transaction, submit the transaction to the blockchain, send funds between addresses, and create new wallets. Alrighty, now let's go through the process of setting up the toolkit and the testnet. To begin with, we'll be using a custom AWS AMI that we've developed. That's essentially a private testnet in a box. All the links to these repos will be in the descriptions below, so let's get started. For security reasons, I've skipped launching the AMI, and instead we're just going to jump into a running one. As you can see, there is no Cardano node running here, so our first step is just to get this thing up and running. To do that, we're going to use a script we created called Bootstrap that allows us to simply configure the private testnet. This is just a wrapper over some scripts that Cardano has provided. In this case, we're going to be changing the testnet magic to 3.1415, essentially Pi, and some other fields as well. So I'll go ahead and run this, and we'll spin up the private testnet. This takes about 30 seconds to spin up, so we can watch that using the Cardano CLI with this command, Cardano CLI query tip. Don't forget to always include your testnet magic. Cue the music. Hey, epoch zero, slot zero, block zero in the Alonzo era. Now that we know that our private testnet is running, let us clone the toolkit for Cardano. You can see there's a Docker compose here. And before we hit Docker compose up, what we're going to do is fund what we call a treasury address. This is an address that will hold all the ADA that can be used to create and distribute and do all the stuff we showed earlier. By default, we provide addresses already in the addresses directory. If you want to create your own, we provide scripts. So you can go into the scripts directory, say generate addresses, and you can create, you know, some addresses of your own. So here I've just made the foo addresses. I'm not going to use the foo ones because everything is configured for our treasury thing. So let's get rid of foo. And let's go ahead and now fund our treasury address. We have another script to do that, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Oops. Okay. Because we have a custom testnet magic, we're entering it here. We're going to call our fund treasury, and we're going to give it the address or the file that contains the address of our treasury address. Huzzah. So now let's poke to make sure that this account was funded, and sure enough, it was funded. Once we've got that, now we can go ahead and just say Docker compose up. And we'll launch in daemon mode so that we'll have the shell to use. And let's take a look. All right, looks like everything is up and running. And that's it, you're done. The only thing we'll look at is, in addition to the web interface, the other interface which you'll probably want to look at is the Cardanodb Sync. And we can do that via psql. I'll show you in just a moment where all these credentials come from. Okay, you can see all the files here, huzzah. And let's go ahead and just do a simple query. All right, you can see this is our treasury. This is the treasury transaction, and here's the amount that was funded, as well as the fees. For the credentials, we have a .env file that Docker uses, so feel free to change those, make sure to customize your testnet magic. And with that, enjoy. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us on Discord or Twitter. All right, enjoy.